From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Dave Guthrow.
And I'm Tama Ponton. Flags will fly at half staff today in honor of Private First Class Buddy McLean.
Private First Class Buddy McLean was part of a group of American soldiers training Afghan recruits. And military officials say on November 29th, one of the recruits turned his weapon on the soldiers, and McLean and five others were killed. PFC McLean's funeral is planned for 11 o'clock this morning at Mountain Valley High School. He leaves behind his 20-year-old widow and 15-month-old son.
The United States Senate has declared today Wreaths Across America Day in honor of the hard work and generosity that goes into the Wreaths Across America project each year. Senators Olympia Snow and Susan Collins wrote the resolution that the Senate passed earlier this month. The project's convoy is scheduled to arrive at Arlington National Cemetery today, where volunteers will lay more than 24,000 wreaths on gravesites there. This is the 19th straight year that the owners of Worcester Wreath Company in Harrington have donated the wreaths.
Well, authorities are investigating a fire that damaged a home in Pownell. Dozens of fire crews responded to the two-alarm fire on Tuttle Road last night. It took crews a couple of hours to knock down the flames. And authorities say because of the house's remote location, tanker trucks had to shuttle in water. Authorities say the owner of the home suffered some smoke inhalation and burns on his hands and feet. Firefighters say the homeowner was using a space heater to heat his house.
Well, if you're looking for an activity today, how about some hunting?
Treasure hunting, that is, with a unique twist. News 8's Cam Tran has the details on the hunt that combines hide and seek with help from the GPS.
Well, L.L. Bean is offering a geocaching workshop today from 11 to 3. And geocaching is basically a high-tech way of finding treasure. And you need a GPS and some coordinates. That's it. Well, the coordinates have been pre-programmed into this GPS. I'm going to find the first cache site. And a cache site is basically a treasure site. And there is actually one right here. Grab it. And once you find a cache, you find a piece of paper inside it and you sign your name with the date and notify people that you basically found the cache. So they'll be offering this session from 11 to 3 today. And the best part is it's free, so you can come out and enjoy geocaching with your family in Freeport. Cam Tran, News 8.
Thank you, Cam. Today is the last day of the three-day food drive at Whole Foods Market in Portland. Customers are being asked to donate a healthy food item as they're grocery shopping. Volunteers are stationed at the store's exit and are helping to collect the food.
Yeah, absolutely. What do they say, 1 in 8 or 1 in 6 children is starving. And so, you know, we can do so much. We have so much. And it's just our way of meeting those needs. There's a lot of people in Maine. You know, we send so much to other countries, but there's great need here as well.
Yes, please.
All items donated at Whole Foods will benefit wayside food programs throughout Cumberland County. 67 food pantries, soup kitchens, and agencies will help to prepare and hand out the food where it is needed.
Well, thanks for watching. I'm Dave Guthrow.
And I'm Tama Ponton. Stay with us, and we'll bring you the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes.